Good morning, everyone. Yes, good morning, because it's 5 a.m. here, as I'm preparing my Baneto for refreshing my Panettone Levain. I hope you guys are doing well. Merry Christmas. And today, it's going to be all about Panettone sourdough. First of all, by no means, I'm a Panettone expert. I'm still learning. I started about a year ago to make some Panettone sourdough. And I'm still in a learning process, and I'm sure it will take a few years before to really understand all of that, especially that I'm learning from myself, so it's really not easy. So I started that Panettone Levain about a year ago, and I started it with a liquid levain. Everyone was saying, you cannot start a Panettone Levain with a liquid levain. I did it. Is it a real Panettone Levain? I'm not sure. Am I producing that what everyone wants to produce in a Panettone Levain, which is the dextran? The dextran is a gum which will give you like all the conservation and all the flavor that you want in your Panettone. Am I doing that? I have no idea. I don't think so. But I have a Panettone which looks like a Panettone, which I can keep for 2 to 3 weeks usually. I did some chef life tests. It's good enough for what I want. So yes, here we go. Let's start. So the Panettone Levain, I started with the liquid levain. My liquid levain, just to give some history, I think it's quite important. It's very active. The pH is around 4.1 most of the time. And what's very interesting with that liquid levain is that sometimes I don't refresh it for like 2 to 3 weeks. And after 2 or 3 weeks, I refresh, boom, it just restarts. It has a lot of life. How? I have no idea, but it's how it is. And it's very, very active. I think if you want to start a Panettone Levain with a liquid levain, make sure your liquid levain is healthy. Make sure it has, you know, a lot of activity. The first time, so I took 300 grams of bread flour, because at the time I didn't have a Panettone flour. 300 grams of bread flour, 150 grams of liquid levain, and it was 90 grams of water. Water will be all the time at 90 Fahrenheit, so around 30 to 35 Celsius, okay? Kind of mix it, kind of get a dough, you know. I don't really remember if, because I remember it was 90 grams, I don't really remember if I added a little bit of water, but you need to have a stiff dough, okay? That's very important. Every time with that Panettone Levain, it needs to be stiff. So mix it, and then I give like 2 single folds, like I will do for a croissant. And I'm going to roll it like you would do for a cinnamon roll or a resin roll, you know. And from that roll, I will take it, you know, turn it 45 degrees, and then I'm going to roll it, like make sure to have a tight ball, okay? Take a knife, do a cross, keep in the proofer. Ideally, it should be 3.5 hours. The first time, it was not like that. I think we were more around 5 or 6 hours. After that 5 or 6 hours, I refresh again. So 300 grams of flour, 300 grams of the levain, and 150 grams of water. 150 grams of water is the must. But I remember that when I started it for the first 3-4 days, I really didn't have a very stable levain. Sometimes I needed to add water. Sometimes I needed to remove water, because at the end of that proofing time, I felt the dough, you know, like a little bit sticky, extensible. So I was just cutting down the water just to kind of keep a consistency of a stiff dough. And I just kept on repeating that process for 3 to 4 days. Knowing that when I was arriving at the evening time, I was refreshing my dough and then doing that same process. So like the 2 to 3 single fold, rolling like a resin roll. And then from that, stop, package in a very tight poly bag. So usually I'm using a poly bag, and I'm going to show you. So here is the poly bag I'm usually using. So you still have some dough from this morning. It's a pretty thick plastic. And I think it's nice because it really helps to keep that fermentation, you know, and that dough really tight. Maybe the only problem is that it's a little bit too thick. So what's happening is your levain, it's becoming quite sticky inside. But you know what? It worked for me, so I just keep this way. Put in a poly bag like this, and then I'm using an apron to really do that very tight package. Here, you can see the photo. And make sure that, you know, we have a fermentation in complete anaerobic world without air. So that's what we want to develop all the bacteria that we need for this levain. So every evening I'm doing that. And then I will keep it room temperature. The best, I would say, would be around 16 to 18 degrees Celsius. But to be honest, last night I kept it room temperature around 12 hours. So, you know, fermentation time and everything, it's kind of doing your balance. So I think it's good enough. And on the next day, we start with the Banetto. So Banetto, what I read on the books, because I don't have any study yet on that on my own, but it's that it's supposed to cleanse that levain, remove the acetic acid, because what you do is that you take 1 liter of water with 6 grams of sugar, water around 30 degrees Celsius, put it inside, and that's supposed to kind of clean that that sourdough. Again, didn't do any study on that. It's supposed to help, so I'm just following the rules here. And then you restart the refreshing, and at least 3 times a day. That's why today I'm here at 5, because I'm going to mix the dough later today. So it's a good 12-hour process between the time that you start refreshing your first sourdough to the time you mix your first dough. Something I didn't talk about, pH. Yes, I think it's very important. If you have a pH meter, use it. I'm trying to target usually around 4.1, 4.2 in terms of pH with a dough which is every time around 31, 32 degrees at core. Because remember, we are going to proof around 33 degrees Celsius, and I usually put 90% of humidity. And now I'm really at 3.5 hours between each refreshing, okay? That's your target, that's where you want to be. Something what I'm usually picturing when before I make a panettone, and when I really prepare that panettone levain, you know, and I refresh it, because I'm usually refreshing it at least 4 or 5 days before to make a panettone, is that I treat my levain like an athlete. You know, it's how I see it. When an athlete is preparing for a big event, you know it well, it will train, it will eat well, and that's kind of what I want to do with that levain. You know, I feed him, I train him, you know, I put him in the proofer, that's the training. Make sure that this levain is ready for the big event. I don't know if that makes sense, but that's really how I see it. And I want to be sure that the levain is ready for the big event, which is the mixing of the dough, because it has so much sugar, so much fat, so much yolk. You know, it needs really to be ready. All right, I think I told you everything. I don't think I forget anything. I don't like to have anything prepared or any text or anything. I want to be more casual. So if you have any question, you can comment on that video, or else just contact me on chefromaindufour.com or on Instagram. I'm trying to answer everyone all the time. So see you next time, because now that Banetto is ready, I need to refresh it. See you. Bye-bye.